Hey guys, I'm back, finally. I know, I'm sorry. It's been a while, I've been super duper busy, but we're back, and we're gonna build something cool. Well, we always build something cool, but we're gonna build something else that's really cool. We're gonna build this. It's the Cauldron Lake General Store. And yes, before you ask, it is indeed based off of another video game. The Alan Wake 2 video game. It's super scary, guys. It's like a horror, suspense, investigative thing, okay? No, I did not play it. I watched somebody else play it as usual because I'm awful at video games. But so good. I can't even tell you, okay? It's a beautiful game. Granted, there's a lot of death in it, but it's still pretty, okay? That's all I'm going to say. Even if you've never seen the video game or heard of it or you don't like video games, this is still a cool build. Okay, the video game inspired me. I gotta tell you all that because, honestly, I don't want to take credit. So, here we are. We're building a general store. And it's a really cool little abandoned general store, all right? Which is right up my alley because I love old abandoned things, right? You guys know me by now. So, here we are. We are just taking this raw balsa wood. I already built all my walls. I know, I was talking through all that. I built my walls, put my door trim and my window trim in. And now we're doing the interior walls because this store is gonna have an interior and an exterior, okay? Because we're doing cool stuff. So I just took this raw balsa wood, not the plywood sheets because it's awful to cut, but the raw stuff because you can texture it really good. And I'm just making a would-be wooden panel walls. And I'm going to do that for the entire interior of the house. So I'm taking those sheets and you probably saw me, you know, scratch them up and stuff for texture. I'll probably show you when I do the flooring because we do the same thing to the flooring. But now we're gluing everything in. We're going to glue everything down. Obviously, we just used some good old-fashioned Amazon Prime cardboard boxes. And that's what I had. I would have used foam board if I had it, but whatevs. Okay, so we're gonna glue our walls in, and here this is the floor. So see, I'm making my lines. I usually use a pencil, and then I scratch it up, and then I use that little wire brush to scratch it up even more to give it more texture, because we want lots of texture. And we're just gluing that stuff in with some white tacky glue. We're gonna fit that piece in, make sure it fits, and it don't. So I mess with it a long while. I don't think I show you that. I hope I don't. Nope, didn't. So, and this little room is like all by itself. This is where the little laundry room's gonna be, okay? So I just took that balsa raw, not plywood. Gosh, I keep doing that. And I scratched it up and I turned it into wood paneling. And here I am, I'm adding the door trim. Because it's so much easier to do while unattached. Things I have learned over time, right? And now I'm going to glue that sucker in there. And that little room is going to be our laundry room. Because, yeah, like I said, campground store. I did say that, right? I think I said that. And it's got like a laundry room on one side and then like the general store on the other side. And anyways, it's a cool little building, especially in the game. And it obviously plays a very important part in the game, but that you don't necessarily need to know that I wanted to build it because it's cool. And I decided, anyways, you'll see, guys. I'm just going to stop rambling. So we're adding some trim, mostly to hide those cracks, those unsightly craps. Unsightly cracks. Guys, I got a new microphone. I hope it sounds better because I know I struggle. I struggle with the voiceovers because the sound is so awful. And I've just been using whatever crap I can find. But I actually bought a legit microphone now. So hopefully this is going to sound so much better. All right. So here we are. We're still gluing in our trim. And honestly, I don't know if the video game general store had trim. But mine's going to have trim. Because that's, yeah. Look at me using tools. Yeah. Just making sure there's wood everywhere there needs to be wood. And I'm trying not to be messy about it because I'm going to use some washes later and I'll explain why. Now we're going to build, we're going to do all of our little windows. are windows, and they're not double pane. They're only single pane, mostly because I was lazy. And we're using some toothpicks there. Those are flattened out toothpicks. And we're just creating the little tiny detail of the windows. And we're using super glue. Yeah, look at me using super glue. And we're using some Instaset stuff. So I use the toothpicks for the inside pieces. And then the outside is just balsa wood. I love balsa wood. Especially the easy to cut stuff. Ooh, Instaset. Love that stuff. I cannot believe I ever lived without that stuff. To be completely, totally honest. I love it. Just bought me a new bottle. Anyway, so now we're painting. It's not straight white. It's like a gray color. It's like a white gray color. All right. Now we're painting some more. We're going to do a wash. Everything's getting a wash, an acrylic wash. Okay. And honestly, when you're dealing with this balsa wood, washes are the best thing to do because you can see all the different colors that come up from underneath. So it gives you a realistic variation. And when I say wash, it's just acrylic paint. I'm guessing I've got a little bit of black and a little bit of burnt sienna in there and a lot of water, just really watered down. And as you can see, it just brings out all the natural colors of the wood. And it's a lot less work than just a thicker paint. You get the look that you want, and it's so much easier. Okay, so real quick before we move on, I want to talk to you guys about another type of mystery game. Okay, this is Red Cabinet Mysteries. All right, these are online games where you basically become the detective. You get all these different clues. You have these puzzles you have to solve. You have to identify victims, and then you have to identify the bad guys, and you have to find a murderer. All right. They're so creative and the storylines behind them are so fun and you get really involved in it. Okay. So the reason I know all this, my sister is the creator, right? She needs game testers right now. So she's in the beta testing phase and she needs game testers who are willing to play, give her feedback about the games, all that good stuff. So watch this quick little video. And if y'all are still interested in becoming a game tester, then you can click the link below.
Hello. Do you want to play a game?
No, but seriously, I really like that music. Okay, we're back. We're going to continue with our build. We are painting the external side of the house. We're just doing a dark black color. Yes. Seriously, though, if any of you decide to become game testers, you have to drop a comment. You got to tell me because, she's been struggling with finding people who will, you know, play the game, follow through, and give her some feedback. And that's what you need. You know, sometimes it's what we need. So I told her, I'm going to ask my subscribers because you guys are the bomb. So anyways, okay, now we're dry brushing. Yes. See, our wash has dried and now we are doing some dry brushing. We're going to dry brush everything, obviously, because I like dry brushing. And it's not white. It's like a light gray again with the gray. I never use straight white. Here we are. We're doing some dirty washing. Okay, we gotta make these window panes look old and abandoned and dirty and gross. Nobody likes to clean those anyways, right? Anyways, So here we are, and I think it's just the same wash that I actually used on the entire house. Now we're going to add some more of that dirty wash to the inside. Now, you have to wait for your dry brushing to dry, though. If you don't, you just ruin everything. So wait for your dry brushing to dry, and then you come in with, you know, a generous amount, especially if you want it to do that drippy, drippy thing. I love the drippy, drippy thing. You got to really load your brush up, though. See, like that? That just looks cool. Am I right? So we're going to do this everywhere. Maybe even get a little carried away with it. I don't know. It just depends on how you're feeling at the moment. Maybe they have a leak in their roof, right? So that's why the walls are so stained. Or maybe bad things happened. We don't have to talk about that. Yeah. But anyways, so don't forget the corners, the floor. You got to add it to the floor. And the nice thing about washes is you can go back and add more if it's just not quite right. You know, if you do it once and you're like, could use some more. Then go back, add some more. No big deal. Yeah, just keep going till you get it right. I always start out like a little bit timid, you know. I'm like, oh, I'll put a little bit here, maybe a little bit there. And then as, you know, as it dries and I see how cool it looks, then all of a sudden I'm just like, everywhere. It must go everywhere. See, I'm coming back and I'm adding like a whole second. And you can tweak the color too. Like you'll see later. Like right now, this is like the brown and the black with a lot of water. And if you want more color, you do less water. You know, more pigment, less water, right? But you can tweak the color too. Sorry, that's my dog is literally sneezing in the background. Are you right, buddy? Yeah, he's good. So yeah, you can tweak the color too. You can add a little bit of green, you know, to make it look like gross and stuff. Anyway, so what are we doing here? We're making shingles. That's what we're going to do. Our siding's going to be shingles, cedar shingles. Made out of not cedar, made out of balsa. They're going to be balsa shingles, but they're going to look like cedar. No, they're not going to look anything like cedar. We're just going to fake it, right? So, but first, before I can lay my shingles down, I got to put my trim up. So that's what I'm doing. And these are those pre-cut sticks. Like, so for the most part, I just buy the balsa raw sheets of wood and I cut from there whatever I need. However, sometimes you can take the lazy route, and I buy these. They're still balsa wood, but they're pre-cut sticks. And it just turns out that they're like the perfect size to use for a lot of different things. And so that's what I'm doing here, because I forgot to put trim on the house. So now I'm doing it, and now I'm gonna go back over it with the same wash that I've used on pretty much everything else. And yeah, that's what we're going to do. And now we're going to start gluing our shingles. Shingles. That is the right word, right? I know that shingles generally go... No, they can go on the side of the house. Oh, my camera has lost focus again. It's like staring at the back wall in there. It's kind of weird. Oh, I didn't realize it was doing that. I'm so sorry. Yeah. Come on, camera. Come back to me. That's all right. You can see what I'm doing, right? So hopefully I don't show you all the cedar placements going on here. But so I try to cut different sizes so it can like look legit. You know, some are skinny, some are fat. Some are longer than others. Some are shorter. The main thing is just, you know, making sure that they all fit nicely. And that's, yeah. In fact, these might be even like a little too big. Anyways, sorry. Focus. Done. Look at that. Looks amazing. Don't know why I pointed there. Must be something that's important. So now we're going to go through and we're going to scratch it up. We're going to add some texture. And again, my camera is somewhere else. Somewhere lost. Okay. So we scratched everything up. You just have to take my word for it. Now we're going to build the roof. And I decided that I was going to do like this whole smart building thing, which I don't generally do. I usually just throw things together, but then I'm like, no, we need a frame because the roof's weird. It's got like two sides that meet together in the middle, and then they like, you'll see, because I'm sure there's like a name for this type of roof, but I don't know what it is. You see it a lot on, you know, trailer houses, and I've lived in several of those, so that's what we're doing. Yeah, so I'm gonna create the framework, and because I'm a carpenter, you're all sorry, I'm totally, yeah, I'm a professional. So, and I'm sure that that's what you build frames out of, is cardboard and balsa sticks for crafting. So I was just going to put a couple of these on there. And I'm like, oh, I just need a little bit. And then at some point, I don't know what happened, but I got carried away. And I decided that we needed framing everywhere. Maybe because I thought it looked cool. And yeah, sometimes it just happens. Okay. So we're still gluing sticks on to create this frame. But I really wanted the house roof, or it's a store. It's not a house. Get it right. I really wanted it to have the right shape. So that's why I did it this way. And I haven't seen anybody else do it like this. I just thought, why not? You know, create the skeleton first so that it'll look good. And now we're just gonna hot glue a bunch of cardboard on. Yeah. And that's what we're doing here. Gluing some cardboard on. It's going to look real crappy at first until I trim it up and then cover it up with more shingles. Well, no, it's not going to be shingles. Well, it is going to be shingles, but it's not going to be wood shingles. You'll see. See that back part? See how that fits nicely? Well, sort of nicely. I mean, it'll look better. Yeah, see, I gave you looks great. See, I finished it off camera and then tried to make it look better. Now we're going to cover up all the ugly bits. All right. We're going to cover the ugly bits with some foam, some insulation foam. That's what we're doing there. We're going to cover that ugly bits. Oh, and by the way, the roof is removable, right? Okay. Because I needed to get to the inside still. So I'm making it removable. So it's not actually attached to the house right now. The foam is going to act as kind of my way of keeping it closed, right? Like a latching system almost. Anyways, so now I'm adding some more foam, you know, to be the brackets under the roof. Yes, because that front part of that roof kind of comes out a little bit. At least it does in the video game. So I'm trying to match that. Wow, that looks messy. Yeah, and so unfocused. I need to fix that. I need to get a new lens for my camera, y'all. They're expensive. They're so expensive. So, little by little, I'll get there. I'll eventually get more professional with my videos. Until then, y'all, just, you know, God bless you. God bless you for continuing to watch me or listen to me. Listen and watch. And just click on my videos in general. Like, it just makes my heart happy. And then subscribe on top of that. Wow. It's great. Okay. We're doing the roofing now. Yes, focus. And this time I'm using very thin foam. Yeah, I decided to use foam for the roof. Don't know why I wanted to switch it up. Oh, yes, I do. I wanted it to be thinner. So the wood worked great for the house, but I wanted foam for the roof because I needed it to be thinner. I don't know why I needed it to be thinner. I just wanted it to be thinner. All right, I just did what I wanted. Okay, all right. Now we're cutting them as we get to that center bit because that's where the cracks are going to be. And there's not really much more I can say about this except for I'm using hot glue. Oh, we're texturing. Use this wire brush to go through and give it some texture, make it look a little rough. And then I take my scratchy tool, which is actually a clay. I think it's made for clay, but I use it for everything. So see me scratchy so fast, so fast. Yes. Look at all that texture. Looks fantastic. Now, normally I would take some Mod Podge and Mod Podge it, but I decided not to do that this time. Oh, now we're painting our shingles. So I decided to go, because in the video game, it's like an old red. Well, what happens to red over time, it turns kind of pink, right? So we're doing like a dirty pink burgundy red, okay? And we're just using a wash once again, because I love the look of the balsa wood with a wash on it. Just, I'm lazy, and that's how it's going to be, okay? So, yeah, we paint this entire thing. Yes, get that in the corner there. And you can already see all the different variations of colors as it's drying. Like, right there. Oh, yeah, where it focuses. Yeah, see those? There's some light ones, there's some dark ones. It just makes your job so much easier. I mean, my job so much easier. Yeah, and I really like that color. I will give you a little hint, though, about using washes as opposed to a thicker paint. You gotta be cleanly with your glue. All right, doesn't matter what kind of glue you use, whether it's white glue, tacky glue, super glue, or hot glue. All right, you can't make a mess. If you get it everywhere, what happens is, when you go over it with your wash, your watered-down acrylics, it just won't take paint. It just won't. So then you got to come back with like a thicker paint and go back over the bad spots, you know? So maybe plan it out ahead of time. If you're like, okay, I think I want to use a wash. I need to be very cleanly with my glue, you know? And I don't know if you guys... If you've watched me glue things together, I mean, I'm obviously a professional. I'm so joking. I am so messy when it comes to glue. Like it's awful. It's really awful. You know, hot glue won't take paint at all. Basically, I mean, it will after repeated trying. But like white glue, I get it all over my fingers, and I'm really bad about it, all right? And sometimes maybe I just like to peel it off my fingers, okay? Because it's kind of satisfying. I totally just admitted that. Anyway, so here we are. We're adding a little extra. We're adding extra. We're going to be, because we are extra today. We're extra, and there's darker paint in places where there would be a moisture buildup in real life, right? I'm being realistic here, guys. And again, I started out timid, and then I'm just like slapping it on there, like where, you know, at first I'm just a little bit here, and then I'm like everywhere. It just needs to go everywhere. And that is a typical sign that I'm getting bored and then I need to move on. And so I'm going to quickly run through it. And yeah, so that's what I'm doing here. Just I'm bored and it's time to move on. So I'm slapping it on there. Yep. Looks great. Yay. Okay. So now we're gluing our dry window frames to our clear plastic that is totally scratched up. I didn't do that on purpose. It just worked out that way. So yep, gluing them on there with some super glue. And now, oh man, I decided that I was going to make legit blinds, like actual, like, you know, trailer house blinds, like what I have in my bedroom as we speak. So that's what we're doing. And it was a very time consuming thing that I did. And you can see, so that was plastic, some white acrylic plastic. I don't think they're acrylic. Are they acrylic? I don't know. No, they're not acrylic. They're just white plastic sheets that I buy off of Amazon. All right. So I cut them all down to size. And then I drilled holes in every single one of them on both sides. Yes. And now I'm using a needle and thread. And look, yep, you can see where this is going, y'all. Okay. It is very time consuming. But in the end, you'll see the results are quite amazing. All right. So here we are. We got it kind of taped down. And I'm trying to get some super glue on there so that, for one, they don't slide all over the place. And I want them to look as crappy as humanly possible. So, you know, I kind of make it so that they're bent and funky, right? Yeah, you're with me. Now we're going to put needle and thread through the other side. Yes. Yeah, we're going to do all of that. And then, and you can't go through a bunch at one time. I tried. It didn't work. And I may or may not have poked myself a few times. Tape is very useful. Okay, so here we are now. I'm going to, yeah, do some more super glue to make them look as crappy as possible. Spooky crappy. And then we do a little spray. Yay, looking good. Now I'm showing you. Okay, we got two sets of blinds. We're going to glue them down to this stick. And I just kind of put that super glue. I'm just trying to make it simple. And yeah, cut those strings off. Yeah, you guys see what I... Oh, man. Oh, I can't wait to show you what they look like in the windows. Looks amazing. All right, and I do trim down. Oh, no, I show you. I trimmed it down. Yeah, see, trimmed it down. And then I do a little wash on there, dirty them up. Yeah. So you guys may have noticed in the beginning, before I started cutting the little pieces, I took a wire brush and scratched the heck out of the plastic. That is all for this purpose, so that it would take paint. Okay, so those are gonna dry, I guess. And now we have lost focus there. We're gonna come over here and we're gonna do some dry brushing. Yes, and it's not white. It looks white, but it's not. It's actually kind of like a pink. It's like the original color, all right? And then I added white. And yeah, so we're gonna do the whole thing and we're gonna overdo it, because that's how I like to do it. And see, it brings out all the little textures. Yeah, see? And then we're gonna do the top too. Look at all those textures coming out to play. Yep, look at them. See, super important, this dry brushing technique, you know? Because, yeah, you gotta throw that right in the middle. And then, oh, yeah, well, we're not done yet. We're still doing more. We've got more to do. More, just everything, everywhere. So satisfying to watch all that texture pop and come out to play. And here we are, we're doing the overhang, you know. And as you can see, I just painted the cardboard right along with it. Yeah. Oh, and now that has dried, we're gonna add some final washes. Yeah, we're gonna add just a bit more. All right, and it really makes it. I'm telling you, this technique really makes it. It does. And as you can see, you know, I may have added a little. No, that's still brown and black. Okay, I thought it was the green. I do a little green later. I add a little green pigment to it. Yeah. See, it looks great. Just this final little, get a heavy in the corner there, because all that moisture buildup, right? Yeah. And heavy on the top and generous, so we have some drippy action going on, because y'all know I like the drippy action. I do. See, look at all that. Doesn't that look great? Looks good. Looks legit. And right around the window, it looks real dirty. Yeah. This is where I added the green. Yep. We're going to add this green pigment all over the top, because we're going to come back and add some moss to it, right? Because it's abandoned and it's in the woods and it has to have moss. Right? So now we're adding the green to the outside of the house too, because I decided I liked the color. It was cool color. And as it dries, it looks even cooler. So we're just going to add a little bit here and there. Yep. Mm-hmm. And now what are we going to do? Oh, we're still doing that. Oh, still drippy. Yep. Yeah, see, as it dries, it looks cool. Just adds it's extra, okay? And we are extra. Now we're gluing in our blinds. Yep, this is the first set of blinds. Wait for it. See, look how, yes, it looks amazing. It's like my favorite. Oh, they look crappy and broken and perfect. That's exactly what my blinds look like in my room. Seriously, they don't go up and down anymore. See, there in this side, yeah. See, we've got some longer ones over there. Look at them all. It was a very time-consuming thing, but oh my goodness, I think it looks amazing. I love it. I'll do blinds again. Okay, now what are we doing? Okay, so we're going to build some interior detail, y'all. And in the game, okay, I'm going to reference the game here, because when you walk into the general store, you see some coolers in the back. All right, some coolers in the background. Now, there are no lights inside of the game general store, but I decided if I was going to make the general store, there was going to be lights. So what I decided to do was take these coolers, right, and put some lighting inside of them. Because when you actually shine a flashlight, at the coolers in the game, it looks like there's a light. And anyways, just trust me, it turns out great. So we just built the cooler, the first cooler, out of balsa wood. All right, so I'm just kind of getting the framework going here. And now we're going to cover the entire thing in plastic, in that white plastic. We're going to use that white plastic. Now here, this is going to be the bottom. So I'm drilling a nice little hole here so we can stick a light through it. All right, so here we go with the light. Yep. And these are not, wow, I couldn't really see that. Sorry. Normally I like the warm colored lights for my builds, but in this aspect, I kind of wanted it to be creepy, right? So I made it one of those cold lights, you know, the colder looking lights. You'll see what I'm talking about when the time comes. So again, I'm just covering like every part of it, even the inside, with that white plastic. And I also, like with the blinds, the white plastic, I took a wire brush and I scratched the crap out of them. Not that I'm gonna paint really the inside, or the outside I'm gonna paint, but not really the inside. But I might throw some washes in there. I guess you'll just have to wait and see. Yeah, yeah. So, so here we are. I'm building these things, and I put a little clear piece of plastic on the bottom because I want the light to shine through. And then I realized, you know, that I needed to make the cooler flat all the way around, so I needed these little pieces there. So that's what I did. Yes. So the first one that you build is always kind of questionable. You learn what not to do when you build the next one. The next one I think goes way better, but I'm not sure that I show you that. So just bear with me. Yeah. So now we're covering the entire outside with the plastic, and we're just using some tacky glue here. Don't really need anything else. Just try not to be messy with the tacky glue, obviously, because I'm going to come back and paint it, and we don't need a mess. So we got that. All right. We're doing the sides too. Yep. Covering the whole thing in this plastic. Yep. It's looking good. Looking good. Yep. Now what are we doing? Oh, we're going to let that dry for a while and then we'll come back to it. Right now we're making a chair. Yes. So in the game, there's like this table and a couple of chairs. Now the chairs are, in the game, they're the, you know, the fold-up ones. What are they called? You know what I mean. There's the fold-up ones. I can't make those chairs. It's trying to create little tiny bars that work as legs. No. So we decided to make it out of wood. Yeah, we made a couple of chairs out of wood. We actually made 4 chairs because there's another set of chairs. But anyways, you'll see. All right, so we're making the chair out of wood. It doesn't have to be perfect, but I do try my best. All right, and it's the legs, the chair legs, tiny little chair legs. Yep. Thank God for that spray. Love it. Mm-hmm. See, there it is. Turned out pretty good. I made 2 of those. Okay. Now we're coming back to the cooler. Yes. I'm not sure why I threw that in the middle of that, but oh well. What's done is done. And we're adding little, because I want it to look like it has like the fan on the bottom, you know, like those coolers do. I don't know if it's a fan. Is it a fan? I don't really know what it does, but it seemed necessary. All right. So it's looking good. Yeah. Okay. So now that we got that built, we're going to build another one. Only this one's going to be like a triple. So that one's like a single, and this is going to be a triple. Now I know what not to do. And so now I'm going to do it right. That doesn't make sense. It doesn't matter. All right. So we make it first out of the balsa wood. You see? Yeah. And I use that little Lego thing that my son made me. It helps create perfect 90 degree edges and sides when I remember to use it, which is not always, but it's a great thing. So now I'm gluing the face bits on. Yeah, gluing the face bits on. We're going to cover everything in plastic now. And you see I have my lines on there, so I have an idea as to where the dividers are going to go, because there's going to have to be dividers, which was real hard to do. Here we are. We're doing that. We got this side and that side. Looking good. Putting some plastic on the top. That's the top, right? Yeah, it's the top. Yep. Got to cover all the nooks and crannies. So I used this clear plastic for dividers, and it was really, really hard to get in there and then the stay, and I had to use super glue, and it was quite messy. Yeah, but it works. You just don't look too close, okay? And then I decided instead of covering this bit with plastic, I was just going to marker color it black. And it worked out fine. Yeah, you know, it and that glue will dry clear, so you won't see it. Yeah, so we're putting those little bits on the bottom. Yeah, look at that. Looking good. Well, no, it looks like crap. But I promise when the glue dries, it'll look better. Okay, so now we're going to drill in one light on one side. Yeah, because we're going to make it so... You know what would have been really cool? And I know they make the lights that flicker. That would have been really creepy. But I didn't have them. And so I just went with what I had, which is these colder, bright lights. You'll see. It turns out creepy and cool. It's great. Okay, now we're just gluing plastic all the way around, all over it, so that the plastic just has the right texture to make it look like it's, I don't know what a real cooler's made out of. It's not made out of metal. Well, maybe underneath it's like an aluminum, but then they put plastic over the top, like a wrap. Or maybe it's not. I don't know. It doesn't matter. Really, it does not matter, and I don't know why I care. Now I'm sanding it. This plastic is really nice to sand because it sands out pretty smooth. And it looks really good. So we're doing the vents on the bottom here. And I'm just using super glue. Yep. I'm getting that on there. Perfection. The first time. Not. We're going to use these, which I'm not even sure what they're called. Found them at the craft store. And I've used them for many things. But in this aspect, we're going to use them for the shelves inside. Yeah. I thought they'd make perfect shelves. Look at that. Turned out great. I like it. Yeah. Now we're making a table. Just randomly, we're going to make the table now that our coolers are drying. And I actually made one more cooler. I just didn't show you because this video is really long. So, yep. Now the legs, which I hate. I hate legs because it always wobbles. Doesn't matter what you do. It's always going to wobble. But it didn't really matter. As long as it, you know, stood upright and it worked. Now, I don't know. What's this? This is... Oh, counter. There's like a couple of counters inside this little general store. Yeah. And so that's what I made there. It's counters. These two little counters. Yeah. And now we're gonna throw in some texture. And look at me using a ruler. Yeah. I know, right? So professional. And now I'm going to scratch them up. Yeah. And I'm going to set that aside. And glue that together underneath. Because I want it dry now. And look at that cute little counter. Yeah, it's perfect. And then this little other bit. Yeah, so there's like a space in between. Yeah. Okay, so now, all right, this was difficult. I am making a washer and dryer. All right, and I just decided to build up the shape with using this balsa wood. And then I was going to sand it as much as I could to make it right and then cover the whole thing in plastic. So it's one of those washer and dryer together, you know, like I think the dryer's on top and the washer's on bottom. I think that's how it works. Yeah. So remember, I'm making a little laundry room because it's a campground general store. And those people who want to stay for a long time might want to wash their clothes. Look, I never stay at a campground. I've only stayed at one campground this past summer because we went to an amusement park and it was really fun. And we had to stay at a campground. But aside from that, I mean, you literally should have heard my kids when they found out there was a shower. We are roughnecks. We rough it. All right. When we go camping, we go out into the middle of the woods, the middle of nowhere. There's no bathrooms. There's no showers. There's a river or a lake. Figure it out. That's what we do. And we wash our clothes in the river, in the lake. We hang dry them like... We're cool, y'all. We're real cool. All right, so I'm sorry. Back to the build. Here we are. I'm just coloring it with a marker because I want to put a door on it, but I want the door to be open, like so you get the idea that it just got left opened, you know? Somebody was rude and didn't close it. And so now I'm putting another little door there. Yeah. And then we got to put some handles on there, right? Yeah. And look at that. Looks like a proper washer and dryer. We got some other dryers. Like, there's a bunch in there. Like, some of them washers, some dryers, you know. Yeah. And so now we're gonna dirty wash them. We're going to throw some dirty wash on there to make it look like they've been sitting there for a while. And focus. Oh, that's better. Okay. So they look gross and crappy, and that's exactly what we're going for. And now we're going to paint our chairs. Yeah, I'm going to paint these ones white. And we'll probably dirty wash them later. And then paint our tables. We got two tables. Because there's like a table hidden in the laundry room. So even though I know nobody will probably ever see it, I decided to make it. Because why not? I do what I want. All right, so we're painting our tables. Yeah, we get that table painted up. Okay, and these are like little store racks? I don't know. I mean, they're empty in the game. But that's where you'd put like crackers and chips for campers to buy, you know, where you put the food. We're going to paint this. Oh, remember how I told you that when you do washes, you can't be messy with glue? Well, now, see, look at that. That's what happens when you're messy with glue. Now you know. And see, I'm going back with dark stuff to cover up my glue mess. That's what I'm doing. Yep. See, now you understand, right? Looks great. Yep. All right. So now we're back to the coolers again, and we're painting them. And we're going to paint them, basically priming them black. I'm going to paint them all black. All the way around, except for the little tiny like rectangle on the top. You'll see I left it. God, so unfocused. Yeah, the little triangles at the top, I leave them white because I come back later with color. And actually, right now. So I painted this green, and then I realized that was not the correct color. It should have been red. The little guy should be green. So I came back and I painted that green. Yeah. And I'm basing this off of the video game. See, the other one's red now. Basing it off the video game and what I see. So that's, yeah. Now we're going to do some dry brushing. Look at that. It makes it look old and, you know, used. Sometimes I just lose my words, you know? All right. Even the colored stuff, we're going to dry brush that too. That looks great. Now we're going to add some dry brushing to our counter. Yeah. Looking good. Yeah. We're going to get that all dry brushed. We're going to basically just dry brush everything. Look at that cute little black chair in this cute little card table. We're going to dry brush that too. Yep. Oh, yeah. And the bigger table. We're going to dry. Yeah. Everything. Everything. Yeah, even the legs. Why not? Yep. Looks good. Now we're going to add some washes to some of that stuff. Yeah. Make it look very dirty and old and fantastic, even the top of the counter. Yeah. Look at it. Looks great. And the chair. Got to be very, very careful with these. These are very delicate. So just a little tiny little dab. All right. Oh, and these are those, you know, shelving for all the goods that they used to sell that they no longer sell. Now, I could have like made little stuff and put them on there, but I just didn't take the time for that. Now we're adding just a little bit of dirtiness to the inside of the cooler because I thought it looked cool. And why not? Right? Right? You with me? Why not? So they look cool. I think it looks really, really cool. Like maybe apocalyptic, you know, or, I mean, post-apocalyptic, right? So now we're adding these names to the top, which make absolutely no sense to me, but that's what they were called in the game. So hopefully I don't get in trouble for doing that. Sometimes I don't understand how all that stuff works, but yeah. So I think they're like Hawaiian beverages. We're going to go with that. Hawaiian. I mean, it's called Ama, right? So now we're taking the plastic, clear plastic, glued it down for the face of both of them, and we're actually legit like gluing these pieces in now. Yeah, look at that. We're getting serious. We're like almost done with at least this video. All right, we're going to have to put it into two videos because don't have enough room for all of it, I don't think. Oh, I made this little dumpster off camera while you weren't watching, and that's where our power's going to be. Yes, and it opens and closes, and it looks so cool. And sorry I didn't show you I made that. Now we're gluing stuff down to the inside. Yes, we're gluing stuff down. We're getting serious. There's our shelving. There's our table and our chair. Yes. Now, I could have gone crazy and added like a bunch of stuff to the shelves or the table, but I didn't because, well, I mean, this video is already long. In fact, this one's 40 minutes. That reminds me, we gotta end this because there's gonna have to be a part two. I mean, it's gonna be up at the same time part one is, but I have to do it in two parts. Otherwise, it takes forever to load onto YouTube, okay? So we're gonna finish watching this. Putting all the stuff inside into our little laundry room. It looks amazing. And then when this is all said and done, which it is now, yeah, we're going to have to, let's look at some photos. See, look at it with the lights on. Doesn't it look good, guys? It looks so awesome. I love it. It's turned out great. Little laundry room. Love it. Super creepy looking and dirty. In the other part of the laundry room. So I promise, guys, I'm putting video two number up right now to go along with video one, so you don't have to wait. I just had to do it in two parts because it takes forever to load onto YouTube if I don't. Okay? So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in video number two. Okay. Bye-bye.